If you're a music lover, you probably buy a speaker with your phone to listen to music louder. But what if you could have them both together in one compact case? Let's make it happen. To design a speaker case like this, we first need a 3D printed case body. But before designing it, we must choose the components that will go inside. All the parts needed are divided in 4 sections. The challenge is to find a compact combination that delivers high quality sound. Let's start with the first and most important component, the speakers. There are a lot of small speakers available online and in stores, but most of them either lack good sound quality or aren't slim enough. I searched for a while and I was almost disappointed. But then I thought about MacBooks. They have high quality loud sound and are also incredibly slim. There are many MacBook models, but I chose the MacBook Pro A1707 speakers. They are compact, slim, and deliver powerful sound, all for under $8. Now we have two stereo speakers, each with a tweeter and a woofer. Next, we need to choose an amplifier for them. I've decided to use two PAM8403 modules, a 2-channel 3-watt stereo amplifier, one for each speaker. Both cost me just $150. The amplifiers also need a way to receive audio from the phone. There are several Bluetooth modules available for this purpose, but the MHM18 stands out for its compact size and low noise. It only costs around 50 cents. Now we need a power supply to power the speaker case. That's easy. We need a battery. There are various slim lithium polymer batteries with different size and capacities. So I'll choose one based on the available space when designing the case. The battery also needs a charging module. I searched through my module box to see what I had and found this charging module with a USB-C input and a battery level indicator. However, since both are on the same module, it's difficult to position it properly in the case. So I decided to use the MHCD42 instead, which offers the same features. I picked it up for only 50 cents, but it doesn't have a built-in charging port. So we will also need a USB-C breakout port like this. To make the power button easier to use, I've chosen this tactile switch to place it on the phone case. With all the parts selected, the next step is designing a phone case to hold them. To simplify the process, you can download a 3D model of your phone case from websites like printable.com and modify it using CAD software like Soundcheck. For a compact and accurate design, we need the exact dimensions of all components. The speakers are the thickest part, so they determine the overall case thickness. Start by placing them in the case, then position the other components accordingly. I've positioned the USB-C port below the phone's port and placed the power button near the phone's button for easier access. A groove is also needed above the MHCD42 battery level LEDs to make them visible. Since there are 4 speakers, I added grills and holes for proper sound output. After assembling the parts, I checked the remaining space for the battery. The available space is around 62 by 51 mm. I bought this 3000 mAh battery, which fits within the mentioned dimensions, for just $5. Now it's time to print the case. For this, we need a flexible filament, and I choose Eson Black TPU. The print requires about 50 grams of filament, which costs roughly $2. After 11 long hours, the case is finally printed. Now it's time to assemble everything. As you can see, one of the speakers has 6 pins. 2 in the middle are not connected, while the other 4 connected to the woofer and tweeter. The other speaker has only 4 pins, all of which are connected to the speakers. Our Bluetooth module is stereo and has 2 output channels. Since we have 2 amplifier modules, each channel from the Bluetooth module needs to be connected to both the left and right inputs of a single amplifier. To adjust the Bluetooth module's output signal level, we will use a voltage divider between them. time to fit everything inside the case. This is the final schematic of the speaker case. A few connections still need to be made inside the case, and they should be done carefully to avoid melting it. This is the final case and it cost me just under 20 bucks. Now it's time to test it out and see if it's really worth the price. The loudness is decent and the sound quality turned out surprisingly good. Honestly, better than I expected. What do you think? Is it worth $20? Let me know in the comments. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next one.